got Brian and Kevin, and of course Matt, because, you know, why not? Uh-huh. We're getting the trains to run. Then we'll show you the layout.
A couple whatever. Fs, a Jeep 40, an SD 40, a couple 45s.
45s. Yeah. Whatever you're we'll in the mood for.
45, I think. That one runs
just
really
one?
Well. Yeah, I don't really have any of them speed matched yet, so.
Okay.
This is just the easiest thing to do, Chuck.
All right. Whatever you say.
Whatever
sounds
you say.
So what is this area here? Locker area?
Also, scenery,
you got
staging.
Some area to work on stuff.
Right, yeah. House over there, which has some more tools and stuff over there.
Okay.
NAPM's cool because there's all sorts of things that you can use. Like, if you want to airbrush something, there's an airbrush that you can just use. There's a whole room with a bunch of paints and stuff. And there's a table saw. If you need a table saw, there's all sorts of tools over there that you can just have them.
Nice.
You don't get to keep them, but you get to use them.
Cool.
The only thing I still
there you are.
Do, but we can is put the baby plate here because
going,
the damn
it's going.
Are they getting filled or are they getting dropping?
They're dropping.
Okay. Because all that is the hops that
quiet,
go from here over to the brewery. So we could use 43.
That's why you didn't honk the horn, huh?
They have a center.
That's beautiful, man.
You're beautiful, Charlie. In the hatches. They make all the different things.
Pin in there.
Yeah.
That's Freighter Mall.
That's Freighter Mall.
27.
And there's about a million more.
You gotta make that safety stuff anyway. Well, that was not very safe.
Six track.
Pretty big layout, eh, man?
It is. It's a very big layout.
I would say.
18 scale miles of track.
Really? Working signals and everything.
Yeah, these signals are set up for free run, so basically everything is green all the time. They'll get greens into greens, just so that everybody has a green. If the block is occupied, it will be red. So that's why this one's still red.
Right.
And it'll go approach and then clear. But aside from that, that's the only thing. You'll get diamonds that are lined both ways into each other. And you just got to keep an eye on it. But during an actual op session, they're real. The dispatcher's actually lining switches and actually giving signals, just like a real dispatcher would.
Right.
Which is legit.
Right.
Thank you.
these empty buckets in there.
Are you recording that? Mother Frill Crossing. This is probably my favorite scene in the entire railroad right here. The city running and everything. It's neat. It's really cool.
You didn't blow for that crossing.
Fuck.
Hey, what the hell are those cars always doing down in the side of the village? Is it storage for
blooming yard.
Oh, yeah?
It sucks.
Why?
It's not too bad. Usually we have two yard masters working during an op session, so there'll be one guy on this side, west end and east end. And when trains, we have actual trains that do work, so they'll set out and they'll pick up, and then the yard guys will have to switch out the set out because it'll be for different pickups for different trains. And it's just a lot of work, and it's a lot of stress on the, everybody's got to work together to make sure that you know what's going on.
Right.
It's neat stuff.
Just be at your table, huh?
Yeah. This is what it is, man. So right now, like I told you before, we have the two modes, the free run and then the dispatcher run. And this is the free run setup right now. So you got the single track main right here and the double track main. During an actual operation session, like I said before, I can actually line switches and give signals.
Right. And you guys use all the telephones out there.
Yeah, we use
radios.
We also have little walkie talkies that we'll use. So I can call up people.
Right.
This.
You know what's hilarious is the move back? It's not mid engine.
That's for the telephones. And that's what I'm speaking into. So there's an actual pedal. To key up my mic, just like a real dispatcher has.
Right, that's pretty cool.
So the actual dispatchers have the exact same thing. Like if you go to RTC Center in Homewood or Fort Worth, Texas, or stuff like that. They have actual foot pedals just like that, but they're keying up their mics from. So it's pretty cool to have. This is the real deal. I mean, this is exactly what a dispatcher in CTC territory looks at.
Right.
All day long, you know.
Yeah.
So that's really neat. We'll line some switches and throw some signals up and stuff. But I can still throw all the switches from here too, remotely, if I want to.
Well, that's all you can see, really. Yeah. Click on the joints there.
That's a crossover here.
The signal changes then.
Yep.
Kind of goes to the switches.
Yeah, these signals are more just for the ops. They won't actually be multicolored in the actual op sessions.
Right.
It's just that's how they designed it here.
Alright, guys. That's about it. Thanks for watching.